conflicts. Certainly, there is one that exists currently with the Recreation Commission that comes to me much to my dismay. I understand that there is a membership quarrel that exists that isn't particularly going well, and I would ask for those members, if in fact they are watching tonight, to please consider, and if I may speak for the Board of Selectmen, that we do put forth that there is a professional code of conduct that we would prefer each and every committee, board, and everything else that exists in Swansea to maintain. I know that the makeup of that board is probably going to change over the next couple of weeks, but still, that will be required then as it is now. Please, I ask you to listen to what I have to offer on that and maintain some sense of civility and dismiss the conflict. With that, and I would also like to say I'm in no position to tell the Recreation Commission or any other elected board what to do, but I do think that we maintain a code of conduct here at the Board of Selectmen. We put forth professionalism. It has worked very well for us. I wouldn't want anything else, and I don't think it's unreasonable to ask that of everybody else.
I concur with that, Mr. Murphy.
Moving right along, the proposed Super Walmart. Apparently, there is a conflict with property issues at the Swansea Mall. That has been brought to my attention, and there are people that are close to that project that said to me that perhaps through the town, the Board of Selectmen may confer with the property management and ownership, the people who own the mall, to identify those specific issues and perhaps move that project along. I don't know exactly what it was. I don't think that it's unreasonable as an economic development issue that we put forth to them, that we have interest in the economic development there. We have interest in something that is beneficial to the Swansea Mall. For its sustainability and profitability. I think that it's reasonable to identify the ownership, who are the responsible parties that are dealing with the situation at hand, identify the problem, and if there's something that we can do for them, I think that we should. Because there's been a lot of interest in that Super Walmart. I think it certainly benefits the people of Swansea. They don't have to drive far. Most people go to Rainham just for the benefit of that store. I think that there's tremendous benefits to the Swansea Mall. I don't know why there would be that type of conflict. But if it was the way it was conveyed to me is perhaps only with intervention at this level may those issues be resolved. They actually asked if we had an industrial development commission. And I said, that really lies with what it's like.
And that's being requested from the mall or from the mall?
That is from project management.
Project management associated with the new Super Walmart.
Yes. I don't want to share the names of companies that are involved. I will share that with Mr. Curran to get you jump in.
I think that'd be wise.
And if you'd like to speak to them directly, as would you, Mr. Winter. So if we can move that along and resolve that issue also.
Very good.
Lastly, I have a couple of communications, one of which is, these things come to others. And this is another handwritten note relative to the trash bags. And I know that these people send them to the town hall, and I think that it's worthwhile.
I haven't seen that before.
But it just came to me today as I went into the town hall. It's just a complaint about the trash bags again. It's not signed. It would perhaps be from someone who has, it is from someone who has distress relative to the bags. And just another, it's just another complaint that goes towards that whole issue about the vendor and whether or not we got what we paid for. Has that been conveyed to the solid waste committee?
We haven't had the solid waste committee discussion yet, but there has been some other research with respect to other communities that use those bags, and I'll share that with the board next week.
And I save those because I would love to share to them there because that's personal experience on their part. The other thing that I have is our new highway employee, William Dominguez, has suffered the loss of his brother unexpectedly. And I understand that the service will be tomorrow from 8:30 to 10 p.m. perhaps. And I thought it would be reasonable because it's during a working day for his fellow highway workers if we allow them an hour to go over there and pay their respects over at Bridgecrest. The guy was 33 years old and he died suddenly and unexpectedly. Can we take care of that, Mr. Curran?
Yes.
I don't know if you're in Swansea at that time, if you'd like me to handle that.
I think.
Call over when I get in at 7:30.
I think those guys, hey, you can do that, but I think those guys, I would hope they would operate that way. I haven't talked to them today, and the highway director's going to be out, so I'll follow up, but you can also give them a call.
I'll call them as soon as I get in at 7:30.
It'd be nice to know, at least that they know that they have the board's support.
Right.
And all this.
I have no other new business. May I have a motion to adjourn?
Mr. Chairman, I move to adjourn at 7:28.
I'm at 8:28.
Yeah, clock check.
I have a motion. I have a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
We are adjourned at 8:20.